Okay, this is a very, very important announcement. Meron na po akong na-research na pwede natin gamitin. I'm talking about all the victims at lahat-lahat na mga nasa YouTube na binalaan din ng Channel 5. Kung totoo man na Channel 5 ang nagbigay sila ng babala na kailangan tanggalin na nila lahat, kung ano yung mga na-i-post nila, kung ano yung mga assumptions nila against Rafi Tulfo. Okay, ito yung pinakamaganda at saka it's a good news for everybody kasi natagpuan ko na kung ano yung specific niya pwede nating isampa against Rafi Tulfo. Okay, please share. Sinabi ko, Mystica's legal action against Rafi Tulfo. Ayan. Rules of Court in the Philippines Civil Procedure. Nandoon yung website para makita ninyo. And ito yung nakita ko. Rule 71, contempt. Okay, Section 3, indirect contempt to be punished after charge and hearing, after a charge in writing has been filed, and an opportunity given to the respondent to comment thereon within such period as may be fixed by the court and to be heard by himself or counsel. A person guilty of any of the following acts may be punished for indirect contempt. Okay, so kung ano yung indirect contempt, nandito mismo sa letter E. Assuming to be an attorney or an officer of a court and acting as such without authority. And as we know, he is acting as a lawyer. And of course, he's using his program as a court here. Okay. So, this is the case of Mystica against Rafi Tulfo, illegal practice of law. Ayun yung grounds natin. Okay. So, sa lahat ng mga victims, yun ang mismong grounds natin. An authorized practice of a law is in direct contempt. Ayon, kaya nandun, section na Rule 71, Section 3 mismo. Indirect contempt, okay? To engage in a practice of law is to perform acts which are usually performed by members of the legal profession, okay? Generally, to practice law is to render any kind of service which requires the use of legal knowledge or skill. So, ang ginagawa niya ngayon, di ba? Ginagawa na niya ngayon na siya yung sumbungan, which he doesn't even have any license para siya mismo yung sumbungan natin. And of course, dahil wala siyang legal knowledge or skill at wala naman talaga siyang diploma or a certificate to prove that he is a legal counsel. So, yun mismo. An authorized practice of law is indirect contempt. Okay. So, ngayon, Rafi Tulfo was or is engaged in unauthorized practice of law. Okay? The court ruled that practice of law means any activity in or out of court. Okay? So, ang practice of law, hindi lang inside the court, kundi outside of court as well. So, yun ang ginagawa niya outside of court. This is, he's using his radio program, ito yung Rafi Tulfo in Action, as a place na ginaganap na niya kung ano yung ginaganap doon sa court mismo. Which requires the application of law, legal procedure, knowledge, training, and experience. To engage in the practice of law is to perform acts which are usually performed by members of the legal profession. Okay, meron ba siyang legal profession? dahil lahat na yung mga ine-exercise niya doon is already a practice na talagang pinapractice ng mga lawyers, okay? But he is not an authorized lawyer, and he doesn't even have any qualification at all to be a legal counsel right here. Generally, to practice law is to render any kind of service which requires the use of legal knowledge or skill. Meron ba siyang legal knowledge or skill? Wala! Dahil nakikita nyo kung paano siya basta-basta na lang mag-judge, mag-rule or whatever, and then dahil din sa takot ng tao, dahil sasabihin nila na, oh, kailangan matakot ka. Kaya katulad ngayon, every time may nagkamali, oh, itutulfo kita. Oh, ibig sabihin na nakuha na niya yung mga isip ng mga tao, na brainwash na niya, na each time na may problema sila, the only easiest way is to go to him. Oh, tingnan mo yung ganun na klaseng panlilin lang sa mga tao. Okay, so obviously with all the evidences being published throughout the world, nakikita nyo, nandiyan lahat sa internet, di ba? Hindi lang YouTube, throughout the world, di ba? Internet. Rafi Tulfo in action was able to establish the pattern in an unauthorized public, unauthorized practice of law. Ayun, na mismo, he is doing an unauthorized practice of law. He's been executing a special role. Ayan, a special role na parang siya na mismo yung legal counselor or power of an attorney. Yan, he feels that he's got a power, okay, in his favor to allow himself to join the complainants and those people involved as one of the plaintiffs as their attorney in fact. Oh, see? Lahat ng mga plaintiffs, lahat na ng mga kung sino-sino involved, lahat ng mga complainants, siya na mismo yung nandoon at nagro-roll mismo. Then, he would file the necessary complaint and offer pleadings, acting for and in his own behalf as an attorney in fact, agent or representative of the parties. So sinasabi niya na, oh, eto, dahil sa ginawa niyo, ako na mismo ang maglalagay sa inyo sa ano, sa korte, okay, ako na mismo ang mag-a-act as the representative para dalhin kayo dito, ganun ganyan, 'di ba? Katulad ng ginawa sa akin, na kunwari, dadalhin ako kung saan ako dapat dalhin in order to assist me, ganun. He was already executing the job of a certain attorney right here or a legal counselor. Okay, acting on his behalf as an attorney, in fact, agent or representative of the party. So he's acting as the representative doon sa mga nagre-reklamo mismo. The fact that Rafi Tulfo has never indicated in his program that he was or he is a member of the bar or any PTR, attorney's role, or MCLE compliance number does not detract from the fact that by his actions, he was and he is actually engaged in the practice of law. So hindi niya pwedeng sabihin na bakit in-announce ko ba ako'y lawyer, in-announce ko ba na ako ay isang member of the bar or any PTR or attorney's role or MCLE compliance number. Hindi niya sinabi yon, pero this will not be a reason na hindi siya talaga qualified doon sa isusumbong natin or doon sa illegal practice of law, di ba? Hindi niya pwedeng sabihin na bakit sinabi ko ako'y lawyer, eh bakit kayo pumunta? Hindi ko naman sinabi na ako'y nakapasa sa bar. Hindi ko naman sinabi na I'm a member of this attorney's role or whatever. Hindi yon ang magiging dahilan niya para tayo ay masisi kung bakit tayo nasa kanya. The fact that he's been there for how many years doing an illegal practice of law, doon siya talaga maitatama. Okay? Under section 3, ayan, E, okay, yung letterang E, Rule 71 of the 1997 Rules of Civil Procedure, a person assuming to be an attorney or an officer of a court, ayan, he is assuming that he is an attorney. Ano bang ginagapanan niya? He is assuming. coming. Meaning, siya yung naglalagay sa kanyang sarili na para bang mediator, or he's already acting as a legal counselor. So ano yung mediator? As a legal counsel. Oh, di ba? Kasi yung mga ipinipresent sa kanya ay legal problems, di ba? Hindi to problema ng kung ano, but this is with regards to legal problems already. Legality, okay? Kaya hindi niya pwedeng sabihin na ay hindi naman ako gumagawa ng mga ganun-ganun. No, he is doing an illegal practice of law right here. Okay? So, ang nakalagay dito, assuming to be an attorney or an officer of a court and acting as such without authority, wala siyang authority, hindi siya nabigyan ng authority para siya mismo yung magiging counselor or magiging mediator or magiging parabang assuming as an attorney. Okay. Ayan, without authority is liable to indirect contempt of court under Section 7 of the same rules. A respondent adjudged guilty of indirect contempt committed against a regional trial court or a court of equivalent or higher rank may be punished by a fine not exceeding 30,000 pesos or imprisonment and exceeding 6 months or both. If a respondent is adjudged guilty of contempt committed against a lower court, he may be punished by a fine not exceeding 5,000 pesos or imprisonment not exceeding 1 month or both. Okay, doon sa mga maliliit lang na nag-commit ng ganung klaseng violation. Pero we are talking to a big person like right here throughout the Philippines and now being advertised, being published throughout the world. So malaki ang pananagutan ng Rafi Tulfo na ito. Okay, so now I am urging the Senate, okay, this is pangalawang urge ko na ito sa Senate, and sana naman lahat ng mga makapanood nito, please i-share nyo ito hanggang sa makarating ito sa Senate, okay? I am urging the Senate to please review the ruling of the court and to recommend that Rafi Tulfo be cited for indirect contempt and be sentenced to serve an imprisonment and to pay a fine. Of course, he has to find the damages like yung mga katulad ko, like katulad ni Adora, like katulad ng teacher, or any other na nagiging victim ng Rafi Tulfo in action na to, okay? To pay a fine and also considering the fact that the repetition of any of the offenses, many times, repetition, okay, many times, he's done it many times for how many years already, or any similar and other offense against the courts, judges, or court employees will merit further and more serious sanctions, okay? So, repetition na yung mga ginawa niya. So, kailangan talagang mai-acknowledge talaga ng korte yung fact na he has done it many times. Okay, I am also urging the Senate to further recommend that a memorandum be issued to all courts of the land to notify the judges and court personnel. Kailangan talaga mismo ang Senate na mismo ang gumising sa korte mismo. Okay, sa korte mismo. Further recommend that a memorandum be issued to all courts of the land to notify the judges and court personnels of Rafi Tulfo in actions unauthorized practice of law. Kailangan kung anong ginagawa na unauthorized practice of law ni Rafi Tulfo, especially in his program na Rafi Tulfo in Action, kailangan na talagang idulog na itong kaso na to as soon as possible para ma-close down na itong programa na to. Okay, so now, with my legal complaints with specific legal grounds against Rafi Tulfo in action, I urge every victim to join my battle against Rafi Tulfo in order for him to be subjected to, ayan, to guilty of indirect contempt under Section 3E, Rule 71 of the 1997 Rules of Civil Procedures and impose on him a certain fine for moral and emotional damages as the cause and effect of his illegal actions. Okay, so hindi lang ito yung magiging kaso para sa kanya, pero kung ano yung na-cause and effect niya na dahil sa kanyang illegal actions, nagkaroon tayo talaga ng moral and of course, emotional, social damages. So kailangan pagbayaran niya lahat kung ano itong mga ginawa niyang illegal actions against us. Okay, yun ang pinaka-importante. Okay.